labeled the Do-Nothing United States Congress. The 113th edition lived up to its name, on pace to close this year as the least productive Congress in history. So it should come as little surprise that some of the top political stories of the year were brought about by Washington gridlock. Take the 16-day federal government shutdown that started on October 1st, a product of a small group of Tea Party Republicans in the House who were encouraged by Tea Party favorite, Texas Senator Ted Cruz, to refuse to fund the government unless President Obama's signature health care law was scrapped or defunded entirely. Ultimately, Republicans lost. Obamacare is still in effect, and congressional Republicans and the Tea Party were viewed largely by the American public as the main reason for the shutdown. And President Obama's approval ratings held steady throughout the debate. But Obama's numbers took a sharp dive after the October rollout of the Affordable Care Act, capped off by the botched healthcare.gov website launch that left the president's approval numbers in the high 30s, making him a potential political liability during next year's midterm elections. Earlier in the year, former NSA contractor Edward Snowden dropped a bombshell when he leaked classified government material to the media that showed the National Security Agency was collecting metadata from phones across the world. The leak set off intense debates on Capitol Hill over the government's surveillance programs. Setting off more debates on Capitol Hill was the announcement that the Internal Revenue Service was targeting conservative groups applying for tax-exempt status. The announcement sparked outrage among many across the country, setting off protests and rallies across the nation. Capping the year of the Do-Nothing Congress are two debates that have waged throughout the entire year: immigration reform and gun control. Hoping to capitalize politically on the tragedy at Newtown Elementary School, President Obama and pro-gun reform Democrats and Republicans began 2013 with gun control on their minds. However, despite their efforts and those of Vice President Joe Biden, the movement ultimately fell flat. Much is the same for immigration reform, although the debate is still alive and well on Capitol Hill. However, even with the Senate's passage of a comprehensive plan, the Republican-controlled House has failed to move on the issue, instead selecting a piecemeal approach to the issue in hopes of passing something that way. But as we close 2013, the issue is still far from being resolved. For WashingtonExaminer.com, I'm Steve Doty.